Hugh Cornwall, you're just off stage. You did fantastically out there. They loved you.
Yeah, I've done a couple of gigs yesterday and the day before, so we're sort of up and running for today.
So the other days were kind of warm-up gigs and today
sort
was the big thing?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, they loved you. I mean, it's the perfect day for it, isn't it?
Yeah. I really enjoyed it. And the sound was great on stage. Everything seemed to work fine. So, yeah.
Do you like doing festivals more than your own sort of gigs? Or?
I don't. If it's well organised, like this one, I don't mind doing it. But when they're not so well organised, then it becomes a bit of a pain. But this one's been so superbly organised. You know, everything's just runs like shipshape. You know, it's good.
That's great. And I know you had a bit of a walk around earlier on. Did you catch any other acts, or did you get any of the interesting food stalls?
I've literally been about, we played for 45 minutes and I've been here about an hour and a half.
Oh, okay.
So
are you going to hang
anything around
a bit?
Well, I've got, I'm playing in Kew on Tuesday, Kew Gardens. So I think I've got to get everyone home. So the bus is going to leave. So I've got to get on the bus, as they say.
Get on the bus in this hot weather. That's such a shame. Now, I know that you're a massive cricket fan.
Oh!
So how
now
are you feeling?
You're Irish.
I'm
Joyce,
Irish,
right?
I know. But hey, I know we're not great, but we did beat Pakistan a few years ago, didn't we?
Yeah, yeah. And what about Ian? We nicked Ian Morgan off
you,
didn't we?
You've nicked a lot of our
and
players.
Rankin's. Well, boy, yes. Rankin's the next one going to get off the block we're going to grab.
Yeah. Now, listen, yesterday, obviously, the Lions, well, they walked all over Australia in the rugby.
Well, I'm not really a rugby man.
No, but
I'm,
is it going to happen in the Ashes?
Well, I think that the English, as usual, are far too overconfident and they're getting complacent, and it's shown in their performances. And most people agree with them secretly or not. And I think it's going to come back and bite them on the bottom, because it's much easier when you're under pressure if you're the underdog. And Australia has been the underdog since the last Ashes. So I think they've made some brilliant moves. They've brought in Darren Layman as the coach. Brilliant. Everyone said, well, it's too close, but I thought it was brilliant. And immediately he's had an effect. He's just, the troops are all responding to him. And I think England are in for a big, big, tough battle.
Now, in between the gigs that you're doing in the next few weeks, will you manage to catch a few of the games?
I won't be able to go, but I'm going to be listening or watching or trying my best to see the lot. I'll see the lot 6 hours a day. It's lovely. It's like the best thing in the world.
Cricket, brilliant. When you sort of look back at the beginning of your career, and when you look around at like some of the different acts, say, at this particular festival, they've come from maybe the TV talent shows, you know, they've sort of had overnight successes.
Right.
How do you feel about, you know, when you started off, it was probably a bit more difficult to crack into the music industry?
Well, you just had to do the legwork on the road. I think that was the main difference. You can't just walk in straight onto TV like you can now. So that's, I think, the main difference. And as a result, I think that the talent that comes out of these TV shows, they don't have that knowledge of performance. So they're learning as they go, you know, which must be more difficult in a way.
Do you think it's got anything to do with the audience and the public and sort of the need for this kind of quick, fast turnover, number ones all the time?
It's instant gratification, isn't it? But that's the nature of our society, isn't it? Instant gratification. No one wants to work for anything anymore, and people forget that the easier something comes, the less value it has, and that's never going to change. And although people try and deny it, I think that's basically a sign of the times.
And I mean, it seems to be a bit of, I suppose it seems a bit unfair or a bit sort of not quite right, really, that the ethos of music in a way is to enjoy it, I guess, for the audience. And punk rock, say, the values in punk rock would have been, you know, everybody for themselves, just sit back, relax, enjoy it. But there seems to be that sort of machine behind it.
Yeah.
Do you find it difficult to kind of, now that you're still gigging, that you're still doing it, that the machine has changed an awful lot?
Well, the machine doesn't exist anymore, and you have to have your own machine these days. I mean, there's obviously the TV talent thing has created its own machine, but the kind of music work that I do, and Wilco, for example, and other blockheads, solid gigging bands, even Van Morrison, they're all hard-working concert performance artists. And it's, we've had to create our own machine, and it's driven by a very loyal audience from a live starting point, and they're the people that buy the records, and they're the people that come to the shows, and they're the people that travel, and they're the people that meet each other and form a community within the fan base. And those sort of things take time to be created. No machine can create that. That's why the business has sort of disappeared with music business, because however much they want, the ones that do exist still want to do that, you cannot create those sort of things. It's like, you know, if you put them into 20 million pounds into a movie and you get a dream cast or a dream director and a dream, everyone's the great, it's bound to be a failure. Because you cannot manufacture those sort of things. You know, they just happen.
And ultimately, I guess it's the fans, it's the audience, and it's building that sort of relationship with them and holding on to it. Can you see yourself kind of still gigging in years to come?
As long as I got my health, you know, and I've been lucky with my health so far, and I live life moderately in every possible way that I can, and it's just down to the health issue, and thank God I don't have any serious issues. So,
well, long may that continue, Hugh.
Well, thank you very much.
Lovely to chat to you. Thank you very much.
Lovely to talk to you too.